You think it's one of the boots?
Oh, is it? Dude, in here.
Oh, I don't.
Oh. What the fuck? I mean, what the?
Okay. Hey, what's up, everybody? So, going on a fishing trip with Dandrin and I'll start in Dangalang Slang in a couple days, and I got this prank spray here. It's supposed to smell like farts. So I'm gonna test it out before I go and use it on the Braddahs so I know it's not like too deadly.
Oh! 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 Oh!
Oh! Oh my god! Ugh. Oh, it does not smell like farts. It smells like raw suet. Oh, I got it on my arm. Oh. What's good, everybody? It is Danny Po'opa'a Pounda D and me, King Kapuka, and Dangalang Slang! Oh. Yeah, he made it. He has emerged. He has found himself in the forest of Lostivity.
Finally.
And he's ready to,
I'm ready to
slay. Let's get at it. We are down here at Nai Ho'omalu Bay. Currently, it is storming on the almost entire island, but we got this little not stormy spot. We're gonna work as long as we can, as well as we can, and yeah, hopefully. All right, we're heading out. Everybody is strung up, of course. Danny's out there first, that bugger. But it's our turn now. I'm gonna be rocking a Castmaster to start off with. It's about a 1 ounce Castmaster, silver. Dadrin's rocking a little light rig right now. He's gonna be just hooking up on some small little fish for bait. And Dangalang Slang's got the Dangalang Slang Extreme. It's a special rig he's invented. Oh, you got one? Oh, Dadrin's already hooked up. Oh, and it's what he wants. A perfect little Hino Slea, dude.
Hino Slea.
A saddle ras, a Hinalea. Nice.
Slay babe.
I'm gonna head out to this little point that's over here. This is the kind of area is where tubbies save your life. This is why you need these kind of shoes if you're fishing in Hawaii, tubbies. It's got felt on the bottom. Lets you walk anywhere you want. All right. Oh, it's so flat today. The storm has just knocked down the water on this side of the island, which is flat. Nice little offshore wind going on too, so it's just continuing to flatten it out. Perfect for fishing. Sean is still over there. I think he's drinking my water. That bugger. Oh, he's pounding water too. He's not even messing around. Looks like we're getting a little bit of drizzle action. Hopefully that goes away. Not what we're all about right now. Rain. Sean just cast it out his first time. Boom. Oh, perfect, Dandrin. Sean just hooked you up. Hinalea. Nice, dude. Oh, Dandrin is ready to cast.
You got that 50-pound braid, live bait action.
Yeah, I really should have sent it out. I don't have a bobber though.
A slang, a big orange bobber out.
All right. Catch me another one, Sean. Catch me another Hinalea. Yeah. Yeah! It's on already! Dandrin's hooked up! Oh, it's something nice! Yeah, boy, that was so quick!
A big snapper.
Thinks he has a big snapper on.
Oh, a big Roy.
Yeah, it might be a huge Roy. Pretty girthy little bugger, though. Nice one, dude. Already, dude. What you got?
Big Roy.
Huge Roy. Oh, that is a scary Roy. Woo! This is the most invasive aquatic species we got out here, guys. Is Roy. And this is a huge Roy. This thing pounds like, boom. This thing pounds like hundreds of native fish every year and is making just so many babies. Let's bring it inshore. It's also renowned. Let's get a nice video too.
These are really pretty, actually.
They're really pretty fish. But they have an unbelievable amount of ciguatera here. So this one is almost guaranteed to make you sick.
Look at that beautiful tail.
Yeah, dude. The whole thing's nice looking. It's fans. Everything on these are beautiful. Except their teeth. Let's see those teeth. Yeah, those are terrifying teeth. Just rows and rows of these little sharp needle daggers. Nice, dude.
Roy boy.
Roy boy. Look at the size of that one, dude. That's your biggest Roy.
He's looking at it.
Let's take him in.
Look at his teeth, bruh.
So we're gonna get this out of the water. Unfortunately, we can't eat it, but we'll do something with it. We're pretty sure it's Danjun's biggest Roy he's ever caught, so we're just gonna go ahead and weigh it.
I speared one bigger, but it's only 2 pound Roy.
2 pounds is pretty hefty for a Roy.
Yep.
Nice one, dude.
Not bad. Get him out of the area.
So that, just doing this has saved more fish than like one person, a standard fisherman takes out from a year. Like these things are just
doing our
insane hunters of this area.
Like doing our part right here, man.
Fish in Hawaii have never really developed a defensive response to this kind of fish. They evolved without seeing them for, you know, hundreds of thousands of years. Then all of a sudden this predator that they've never recognized shows up, and the Roy are actually able to just swim up to a lot of the native fish. Literally just swim up to them and eat them, and the fish don't even react. They're just like, oh, what is that? And then boom, they're done.
Need a new hook.
Ooh, new hook.
Yeah. You catch one Hinalea though?
Yeah! Ooh. How's your grapes in here?
Oh, bad.
Just in case you get hungry.
Cherry.
They're not cherries, though.
But they are. They taste like cherry.
Me and Danjun are both running our large dunks. I got shrimp on. Danjun has some nice light bait on. If Sean catches some more Hinaleas, I'll have some nice light bait on. The rain is picking up, but, you know, it's supposed to be way better fishing in the rain, dude.
We're charging right now.
We're charging, dude. It's storm or shine or waves or not. We are out here. We're trying to catch some awesome fish. You know, it's not bad to fish in the rain sometimes. It's kind of cool. Sean's now been over there for approximately 10 minutes. Kind of just checking out his hands or something. I think somebody took my bait again already. Dude, shrimp is not working out here. The huggies are just mopping. The slanga is coming back. Oh, that feels like some huggies, dude.
Yep.
That's what it is. Look at this dangle. Got a dog, yeah. Almost, almost. It's still a little bit tangled on the tip.
On the tip?
On the tip.
Just the tip?
Yep.
Oh, there it is.
There you go. D-dang.
Ooh, that was a close one. This could have been bad.
It could have been bad. Could have been dang-zastrous.
Okay, I'm gonna get some more Hinalea.
Yeah, just nail one real quick, dude. Yep, you got dangle on, dude. Oh, he jumped into a rock. Wait, let go loose for a second. He might pop back out.
Rock.
Something dove super hard instantly.
How do they that
let it go
strong?
Fully loose.
How did that
let, he might come swimming out if you just leave it alone for a second. They're just mokes, dude.
Little Hinalea?
Just grabbed it and whoop, ran into a rock. It's gone instantly, dude.
Like literally.
Shred you, dude.
You do the 1-2, buckle your shoe under a rock, under the tree.
Under the dock.
Under the dock. With the sock.
Oh.
me with the rock.
Get out there, Sean.
Get out there?
Yep. Sean is banging out. In the rain. Take it slow, boo. Or you can just swim over there. Just gonna walk over and pull it to the other side. It loose? Now you don't have to reset it up.
Oh.
Cherry. Nice job.
Oh, Uncle John.
Uncle Dangalang Slang.
All right.
Oh wait, actually here, put your shirt on first.
Put my shit on.
200-pound rule coming in, boy.
Yeah.
Nice. Sean has just tried something innovative. We had some mealworms from this little bird that I saved. Yeah, had some mealworms, and Sean put a mealworm on his hook, and it caught this little stick fish.
Yeah, that's a sick little guy.
Nice, dude. Mealworm power. So we had ourselves a little question. Could mealworms like this catch fish here in Hawaii? Yup. Sure can. Sean just proved it. You can keep this in your pocket, little like bait thing.
Thanks.
Now me and Daniel both have some primo bait out.
Yeah, let's do this, dude. It's one hammer right now. Okay.
Scared now. Now that we've properly scared every fish out of this area, we can wait for them to come back. Sean's wrecking the Kinaleums, dude.
Yeah.
I mean he's using the mealworms.
Oh, that's when he caught that on?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah.
He caught that on a mealworm?
Yeah. He's using more. I gave him the whole case. He's got them in his pocket.
Yeah, buddy. That's Sean.
Yep.
We brought the net out here.
Sean Mealworm Dangalang.
Mealworm Buzz. Speaking of mealworm.
You'll see what. So this is our experiment for the day here. We just got a mealworm right on a hook. Sean's already shown that it does catch things. He caught that little baby aha. Let's see what else he can catch, dude.
Nah.
Oh, it is snowing on Mauna Loa right now. Mauna Kea too, guaranteed. Yep, you can see a little bit of snow up there. Got a better lens, you can see it. But there's snow on both Mauna Loa and Mauna Kea, the two mountains in Hawaii that actually do snow. So if it snows nice and thick, we're planning on actually going up there and making a nice little episode.
All right,
so
go that way.
Hopefully that comes through.
We'll get that line on that.
Oh, we got double dangalangs right now. One right here. One dangalang. Number two dangalang over here. Yeah, Dandrin dangled hard. Dandrin is going for it. Sean is dangled too. Nice, you're free. Atta boy. One dangle down. Now we can work on number two. What you gonna do, Sean? With that dangle on the line, he got a fat fish and it just went underground.
Man, he's fishing.
I might be out right now, dude. Reel it in. Yeah, it's free, dude.
Is it?
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah.
Oh, it is.
Yep, you're free. Woo. Cherry, still got your hook too.
Thanks.
Stoked.
Yeah, oh, buddy.
We have a traditional dangle here.
Oh, baby.
No way.
He's not going to be able to get that on.
Oh, no. Wait. That's knotting up. Some knotty dreads.
He can figure it out if he truly wants to. You can figure it out.
You can do it, Sean. Oh, the face of determination.
Oh, so you gotta follow it, okay.
I'm down to go over to that other rock.
Oh,
oh, he did it.
Oh!
Champion detangler. We're switching zones. Looks like that Roy had mopped everything beforehand, so there's not much going on here now. We're gonna rotate, head up to a little rock over there. The wind is starting to come from the south instead of just offshore, so we're just gonna switch it off to make that helpful for us instead of just wrecking us. Oh, Chokinole is in here, dude. Get the net.
There's in there too.
Should just net us something. Couple maninis.
I want a little kupipi.
I want a little rock hopper, dude. So we changed spots. We're sampling out this area. Got my one line just hooked up in the rock there. Whipping out this cast master a couple more times. Here comes the dangle slangle. Sean's talking on the phone. Daniel's getting ready to slay. Yeah. Did a nice little switch up here. That cast master was just not working out at all. So I just put a little bobber on. I'm just gonna send out some shrimp, just catch some fun stuff. Maybe some big fish will come by while my dunk is out there somewhere. Sean is dangalanging over there under the tree, talking on his phone, living the dangalang life. Dandrin is way out on the point, beasting it out there. Here's one fish coming up, guys. Zoop! Oh, I had something. Dove right into a rock, popped off. Got some rock divers today out here. Just catching some little hinaleas right now, right here. Boom! Oh, that bugger went into a rock. Almost lost my gear. Boom! Oh, they're whacking it so hard. These guys are nuts. They're doing drive-bys. Oh, they took it. All right, well, when they're taking your bait like that, what you gotta do, put on a smaller piece of bait. Oh, these Himalayas want to scrap. Kama Himalaya! Woo! Hinolina, Hinolina slay us. A nice little one. Tsunami alarm's going off right now, but I think, isn't it just a testing? It's the first of the month, right? What time is it? Is it 11:45?
Yeah.
Okay, it's the testing.
Well, you knew what time it was.
Okay. Here we go, boo. 10 pounder coming up. Yep. Tsunami alarm's turning off. It was a test. What's Sean doing? Dangalang Slang, every time he comes out, he just loses himself under a tree. See this, everyone? Look at Danny Vision. Mean.
Hey.
If you guys want Sean to get off his phone, leave a hashtag, Sean get off your phone comment, and we'll get those to him. We'll sign a petition and send that out to get Sean back out here to fish instead of cruising under that little teeny tree. Hashtag slacking Dangalang.
Hashtag slaps when we get home.
Hashtag false cracks definitely riding in the back of the truck, Sean. Ready for this huge Milo, dude?
Ready, bro.
Yeah, you think so? Because it's about to whack. It's about to crack. It's about to pack, pack, pack.
Great.
Yeah. Oh yeah, now he's just, Sean just moved farther back into the trees so that we can't give him as much crap. Oh, there he goes. He's going to step farther now. He's just going to walk into the sunset and be gone forever. That's it. Say, okay, bye, Dangalang Slang. That was fun, guys. Dangalang Slang's gone for another few 20 episodes. I'm sure he'll wander out of the bushes one day and we'll see him again. Shoot, Dangalang. All right, I'm going to cast that one out a few times. Use some of that shrimp. Got a little something. Oh, little teeny Hinalea. Sean has found his way out of the bushes. It's pretty crazy.
Right. Deep. Found some cool rocks, some snails. That's good.
Nice. Snails, dog?
Yeah.
Aw, brah. Down jelly. Oh, we got the first huggy of the day. That's a good sign. Things are turning around.
All right.
Huggy style. Our favorite fish, because we catch it so much. Looking as huggy-licious as ever. Huggy, huggy, huggy. He's got a huge piece of shrimp way out there on a bobber. If anything moke swims by, hopefully it'll want to bite it. Wait, you got one?
Yeah.
Oh, Sean's got a moke on.
Oh.
Yeah, Sean. Huge hug. Oh, work it, Sean. Yeah.
It's heavy, bro.
Yeah. Whoa. Whoa. Huggy. Whoa. Yeah, Sean, bro. Stepping it up, dude.
I want to catch one.
One huggy at a time, bro.
He's going to bark at me, bro.
He's going to. Or poop on you.
Oh, I got a huge huggy.
Oh, now Dander's got a huge hug.
Oh, poor guy.
The huggies are lit right now.
Huggy battles right now.
Episode 3.
Look at that bro. Bend, right? Yeah.
Oh.
Look at that.
The huggy's not even messing around.
We're up.
Getting that hook out, Sean?
Trying, dude. No, Dander's trying to take it off and he broke it. Oh, nice, that a boy. Oh, he's stoked.
Yeah, he's way more stoked.
Oh,
here you go, bro. Well, we're officially hungry, so we're just gonna toss all of our shrimp on our big bobbers, one by one, whip those out. Dander's doing the same thing over there. Hopefully we'll hook up on something huge, and if not, we'll be, you know, cherry anyway. Woo! Oh. Dang, guys. Felt something whacking that. Oh. Shrimp is probably gone. Yep, shrimp is gone. Took my bait again, that bug. Oh. Probably some giant king huggy out there just regulating. Oh, here comes Dangalang Slang is returning again.
Oh,
Sean's got us something on. Yeah, Sean.
Woo!
It's a, what is that?
Hinalea? What is that? No, it's a,
what is that? Oh, weird looking huggy. This is a really weird huggy. It's got like totally different color scheme than all the other ones we caught.
Wow, it's really nice color though.
It's got like pretty, nice black and white instead of blue and like
chill,
green.
Bro. Oh, try to bit me. Look at the, yeah, the tail's all like orange and then like white.
Come show, yeah, there, move your hand. Oh, that's a weird one, dude. Really never seen one that color before, though. Yes. That's cool.
Yeah, dude, can you de-hook them?
Oh, you can do it.
Alright.
You're a Braddah. Mm. You're on the shore. Okay. You're whacking my head with the kind.
Yeah.
Oh, he's free. Sean's gonna return his crazy looking huggy.
Bro, it's so cool. Look at this. He tried to bite me, but look at that beautiful fish, dude. It's cool.
Cool looking huggy, bro. All
right. Go back, breed more of you guys. I'm tired of looking at those weird black blue ones.
Sean's gonna get his final cast.
The little tail part of the shrimp.
I'm gonna do one last little cast too with these couple little scraps. It's not even a real scrap.
Oh, what the?
That was mean.
That was horrible. Yeah, there might be a little something in here though.
Probably a little something in there. A little sauce. Oh, there's a big honu right there.
Oh no!
Going dude, right towards your bait. One, no, that's the honu, dude. Oh, he's going straight towards the reel end. There's two honu. Oh no! Oh, okay, good job.
Dude.
There's lots of honu coming through, dude. There's two of them right there.
It's like a school of honu.
Oh, it's a whole new school.
A whole new school of lovely seaweed.
Oh, we got some bait box down in the water over here. Sean's gonna go be a beast and grab it.
It's gonna be really cold. It's not cold.
A little bit cold.
Okay, it's the second time today.
Yep, champing out there two times in a row. Oh, Braddah. Uncle Dangalang's heading out.
Uncle Dangalang.
Oh, go slow, go slow. Oh, shot. Yeah, it is eel territory. Take it slow, boo. Oh, it's going the wrong way.
Get over here.
Come on, Sean, you got it. Yeah, champion.
Okay. No more Malama the ocean, cuz Malama Kai.
Oh, Malama Moana. He made it. Champion of the Malamas. Ain't no plastic styrofoam getting in there from us. Alright, here you go, Sean. There's no more bait in this area.
Yeah, we're pound.
No more bait?
We pounded it all.
Oh, man, that's good.
Everybody come up past over here at the point.
Okay. Shoots.
Oh, bro, I got four fish today.
Yeah, you did a little slaying, dude.
Yeah, that was action.
You got some dang-a-langin', dude.
Dude, I kind of want that huggy. What if that was like the super rare species?
Totally, dude. It's worth like,
there's only like four in the world.
$200,000.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, there's only like four left and he's worked it.
Made bang. Like, some rich guy.
Poachers. I collect huggy.
I don't have that in my tank at all.
I don't have that color of huggy yet.
What color is it?
I'll give you $2 million for that huggy.
$2 million.
The $2 million huggy. Daniel's getting the last couple whips out. Put the Castmaster on for one final little throw. Me and Sean have thoroughly used all the bait, so good job, Sean.
Yep.
Danger is a true Braddah. We're totally packed up, freezing, and he's out there just...
still gone.
He got that big whack of a fish, and now he's hooked. He really wants to catch it, you know, but...
But some but people are starving.
Yeah, we're all out of bait and hungry. We already caught some cool fish, I think.
Bruh, come on. Who's seen a huggy like that?
Who's seen a crazy huggy like
Let
that,
Let us know
dude?
If you've seen a...
Yeah, if you've seen like a huggy like that. Let us know. We hear it's worth $200,000 per huggy like that.
And I'm an idiot for...
Let it go. $200,000 huggy gone. Oh, he's making his way back.
Oh.
Hide over here. Hurry.
Out skis.
I'm going to go tuck in by this bush.
What are we doing here?
Daniel's going to cast two more times.
Yep,
let's bounce.
Oh, what the hell is that, dude? Oh, I think it's these, bro.
Ooh.
Smell it. Here. Is it?
Oh, baby! Oh, shoes are the stinkiest shoes ever.
Oh, what happened there, bro? Oh. you're like, you've got that faint smell.
Oh.
Is that what it is?
Oh, just take a big whiff, dude. No? Try the other side.
I don't know, but I...
Oh, these shoes are nuts! Oh, it's making them like die! Oh!
Oh, that's horrible.
That's nuts.
These shoes are destructive.
Crazy, bro.
God damn, dude.
Hey, where is he? Look at him out there.
Oh my god. I feel like it's everywhere, all over me.
Is that smell just so penetrating, dude? Oh yeah, I can just smell it.
Is it my jacket? Here, smell my jacket.
Dog.
No. No, it's not? Okay.
At least not your shoulders.
What the f***? Wow, that's ridiculous.
Oh, he's being crippled by the smells. Dude, Dandrin's one last cast is like 15 last casts. So desperate to hook back on to him. I'd be stoked if he did though. That'd be crazy. Come on. One huge one, boy.
Uh-oh. You smell that?
Yeah, totally, dude.
Oh, where is this coming from?
Some weird pig.
Crazy.
Yeah, pig manure just came.
Oh! Yeah, Dandrin caught our last fish, everybody! What'd you get? What's the last fish of the day? Oh, is that a Roy?
Yeah.
Nice, dude. Two Roys out of here. Awesome. Nice, bro.
Get that freaking Roy out of here.
That's why there's no other fish, dude. These Roy are just mopping. Nice. Not as big as the last one, but you know, it's pretty. Scary mouth.
Dude.
Beautiful. All right, well, you know what to do.
Yep.
Oh.
Ooh.
Did you finally
come? Oh! Alright, got my hat back. Here we go again. Oh, it's so cold and windy. Over it.
Bananas.
Oh.
What the f***? What the hell is it? Why is this sitting here?
Oh, I can totally smell it, dude.
Oh my god.
No, I'm Jerry.
Everywhere. Smell it.
No.
Here, does it smell bad?
No? Oh. Maybe a little bit.
On my arm? You need to go take a shower right now.
We gotta get out of here. Windy, we're getting crushed by stuff.
Oh!
Oh, shark!
Oh, where is this coming from?
I enjoyed this. You smell it?
Not super nuts. Let's get out of here before that smell follows us.
Making our way to get food. Yeah. So we had our doubts, guys, on today, and decided just to go for it.
It was awesome.
Next time it won't even be a question.
Even if it's raining like it is right now,
lightning and
we're just gonna fire, go, guys.
Lightning and fire, we're good.
Oh, that sounds like a tsunami coming.
Even today we had the tsunami warning, but you know, even through that, survive.
Dan and D caught the Roy of the day.
Yeah, two Roys.
Well, I'm kind of a bunch of huggy.
Keenly has a Huggy, don't know why.
Yeah. Sean caught the rarest Huggy of them all.
$200,000 Huggy.
Green, like an orange tail and white and fries.
Maine.
Maine.
That sounds pretty mean.
Maine.
Six stick fish.
So stoked.
Go Sean's. Are you going?
Oh my god.
Sean's order form here.
Barefoot Sean.
Oh, barefoot Sean. We'll be outside, Sean.
Hey, grab your, not gonna leave your sticky shoes in here.
Yeah.
What flavor is that?
All right, guys. Well, that's it. We're gonna eat some food. We're pretty hungry. Dadrin nailed some pretty solid Roy.
Couple nice Roy.
Did some solid things for the environment by taking those out of there. And
nice Huggies.
Yeah, Sean caught his rare super Huggy, never seen before.
Made it out with Sean today.
Yeah, Dangalang made it out. So, you know, he's lost. He's back in the episodes. Stoked.
Yeah. Till next time, guys.
Doosh.
Shoots.